Thank you for joining Wars of the Roses as we begin with Practical Occultism or Eth Hierarchic Forces. From Order of the Magi, Priest and Princes of Melchizedek by R. Swinburne Clymer, issued by Department B, the Philosophical Publishing Company, Quakertown, Pennsylvania. Practical Occultism or Eth Hierarchic Forces. Primary textbook for the members of the Magi. In God's great universe, there is a storehouse of power, and in man, there is an embryo, a receiving station. The universal storehouse is open always so that all may draw upon it, and the receiving station in man is at all times ready to be awakened. All that is necessary is for man to gain wisdom that he may know how to awaken the center within himself, and then he can draw upon the universal center for power, can receive and store it, that he may have it to use according to his needs. We, of the secret schools, term this great force which is available to all men the Eth. We have thus designated it because it is in the air which we breathe and which surrounds us. It is finer than the ozone in the air, which, though capable of giving life to man, nevertheless cannot confer immortality upon him. While the Eth is in the air and we inbreathe it continually, unless we gain knowledge, we cannot separate the Eth from the air, and thus it escapes from us when we exhale. In practical occultism, the instructions have been so simplified that there is danger of their being considered too simple. But let us assure you of this, that if you follow the drills and exercises, then you must and will succeed in whatever you may undertake along the occult or mystical path. You breathe now the same air that the Master does, but you are unacquainted with the law that governs the separation of the Eth from the other constituents of the air. Are you willing to remain ignorant of the law? You may be weak, sickly, grouchy, and a failure. If so, you alone are to blame. The Master is a master, not because he is different from you, but because he sought wisdom and applied the secrets that he learned. The Eth forces may be properly termed the life of the soul. They are the power of the soul. The Eth is the force and energy that the soul must use in its work, just as the mind of the materialist must employ magnetic forces in his efforts. In the one instance, the forces are immortal and powerful. In the other, the power is only temporary and may actually bring destruction to the possessor, and that he may, consciously or unconsciously, use his magnetic power for evil or destructive purposes. The Master can employ his Eth forces only for the good of himself and others. The more enlightened the neophyte becomes, the greater wisdom he gains, the purer his faith in himself, his Creator, and mankind, the more natural his life, therefore in exact proportion to his own activity, will be the Eth forces at his command. Gradually, as the Eth forces are accumulated, as the illuminating process goes on, the seat of intelligence, that is, the directing power, will be removed from the brain to the soul center, and, therefore, man lives and plans, not in the mind, but in the soul itself. Power within man. Power is within man. It is through the interior preparation that man is able to accumulate and hold the mighty Eth forces. It must not be understood that man himself actually possesses the power. It no more belongs to him than does life. He has life, but he receives it continually from the universal storehouse of living forces, because he has a body that can receive it and retain it. Thus, it is with the Eth forces. He receives them because he is prepared. He holds them because, through wisdom and a proper preparation, he is qualified to hold them. The Eth forces come to him through his attracting power as the result of training and development. In ordinary life, the force in man that makes for health, happiness, and success is personal magnetism. And admittedly, it is far better to be in possession of personal magnetism than to be a mere negative machine that is at the mercy of everyone. Gradually, as a man gains wisdom by following wisdom's path to enlightenment, this magnet power, which is purely of the mind and of the body and has nothing to do with the soul, is forced to give way. It continues to be used as a base. It is transmuted, wholly changed, and the F forces take the place of the magnetic force. The king is on the throne in the center, instead of in the brain, and the body is the vehicle through which the F forces play. The base of power. The base of power is in the soul. This is a statement that cannot too frequently be repeated. It is necessary to do so in order that the truth may become firmly rooted in the consciousness. While we affirm that the base of power is resident in the soul, we likewise claim the power itself to be the fiery eth, unless the aspirant fully prepares himself so that the base will be harmonious with the vibrations of the eth. It will not be possible to retain this eth, even if it be drawn in with each breath. The threefold development. Unlike the development of magnetic power in man, which depends entirely upon the state of mind and body, the increase of eth in man will result after the harmonizing of his threefold being. Magnetism is the result of a development that merely increases the health and bodily strength of the individual. Thus, it is true that he may become powerfully magnetical and thereby be able to influence his associates in business or in any other way in order to gain success. But the soul itself may be as dormant as the day he was born. In creating a powerful eth center or attaining to occult mastership, the condition is far different for the reason that a man is not able to become a master, draw in and hold the eth forces or fires, unless he also develops the soul center in harmony with the body and the mind. Storing the eth forces. Accurately speaking, no man can either generate or develop the eth forces. The eth spheres are filled with it, even to overflowing, and it neither can be decreased nor increased. The work of the aspirant is to develop his body and awaken his mind, that he may become a fit instrument for storing and distributing this energy. He can develop the divine spark within himself that he may become like unto a living fire. When he has accomplished this, when he has, through simple methods, prepared the body and aroused the soul, causing the soul to be a divine fire, thus he is enabled to act as a medium between the great storehouse of eth, the hierarchic bodies, and those conditions which he seeks to influence. It is thus more correct to say that the eth priest draws upon the eth spheres, the eth hierarchies, for his power, and he acts as an agent in transferring it to others. The more awakened and enlightened the soul is, the greater will be the fire within it, and, for this reason, more of the eth fire may be drawn to it and then transferred to whatever object may be desired. The mind of man is not the power, it is merely the director of it, the agent for accumulating, storing, and transferring this fiery energy. The neophyte should bear in mind always that he can draw in, retain, and transfer only such an amount of power as is made possible by his development and by the intensity of the soul fires within. Thus, it remains a fact that he can use the eth only to the extent of his development. The more he purifies the mind and body and prepares them by making them strong, healthy, vigorous, and natural, the greater will be the development of the soul within, and the more will he arouse the fires of the soul. There is no restriction whatever except that which the neophyte, through his thoughts, desires, and acts, places upon himself. Practical list of contents of practical occultism. The teachings of the masters. There is nothing mysterious in the eth power. the sacred fire within, what it is and how it may be aroused and developed, possession of this power and how it may be obtained, the true occult master, the master of all ages and the forces they employed, the F forces and their development, the fires within, individuals differ, but all may develop the F within. Men sell themselves. That is why they succeed. Some fail because they lack both personality and individuality. Mind is not the power. Power is of the soul. Power is in each one. In most men, it is merely dormant and they are ignorant of their strength. Man, a generator of power. Ignorance of the laws has been the reason for death among men, throwing away power. Most men constantly do so. The first work, necessary for the development of F power. Man is surrounded by the power but fails to recognize it. Power may be good but weak. How to strengthen it? In the beginning, faith a necessity, a mystery that all may understand. Men have equal opportunity but few take advantage of it. Wake up, live, direct your energies. Do not be the plaything of fate. To fail is a disgrace. All men may succeed. The body, its importance to the true occultist. The hierarchic powers, a mystery that all must comprehend who will become occult masters. The great center. Success in the occult depends entirely upon the development of this center. The action of the ETH, the employment of the force, the great laws, everything is under the law. In the 19 laws here given will be found the secret of development, instructions, and the mantra. Exercise number 1, exercise number 2, for holding the F fires. Further instructions and second sacred mantra. Exercise 3 for directing the F fires. The third sacred mantra. If you fail, it is because of feebleness of will. End of the instructions. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to share, like, subscribe, and comment. And if you can, please consider donating to Wars of the Roses. Links to PayPal and Patreon are in the description. Thank you so very much.